And we are beginning tonight with a Highway 101 horror.
A bus loaded with 36 people on its way to Santa Maria flipped over onto its side, killing at least four.
It happened just before 3:30 this afternoon on 101 just north of Soledad on the Front Street overpass. It was quickly declared a mass casualty incident. Responders came from all over Monterey County. The highway was closed for several hours, but the CHP was able to open northbound lanes tonight. Traffic is now flowing slowly in both directions.
This was the scene about 90 minutes after the accident as emergency crews scrambled to get the injured into ambulances or helicopters and get them to the hospital as quickly as possible. It was quite a project considering how many were injured, dozens. We're told tonight that 34 of the people on the bus were French nationals. A Canadian tour guide was also aboard and an American was driving. Of the injured, four are teenagers.
We have live team coverage tonight. We begin with Stephanie Truong, who has details on what happened on Highway 101 today and who was on board that bus.
Dan, that's right. We're live on the Front Street off-ramp, and it's heading into Soledad behind me. Above that, of course, is the overpass where the accident happened, and Caltrans crews and investigators still trying to figure out what happened and where to go from here. Just below that is where three to four of the passengers were ejected onto Front Street by the railroad tracks. We spoke with one woman who was actually one of the first witnesses on scene. She saw those victims on the ground. She says it's an image she's not forgetting anytime soon. A massive emergency response was launched both air and ground Tuesday afternoon, just minutes after the tour bus crashed. It happened on the Front Street 101 overpass in Soledad, killing several people aboard the bus.
The tour bus was coming southbound and for an unknown reason drifted over and struck the center divider guardrail, and at that point overturned onto its side.
CHP stopped traffic in both directions of 101 as ambulances raced back and forth with the victims. At least seven helicopters transporting those in more critical condition to Bay Area hospitals.
Everybody was like in a panic.
Soledad resident Lorena Salinas was one of the first witnesses on scene, driving into town on Front Street.
There was blood everywhere, you know, but, you know, there was clothes on the hanging, coming down and everything. That's all you can see.
That's when she saw three victims who'd been ejected from the overpass down onto Front Street. All adults, only one was moving. Above her on the overpass, Salinas says she saw a teenage girl yelling for her mother.
My eyes got all watery because I seen that girl yelling for her mom. You know, all I heard saying, "Mama, mama," you know, and screaming. And they're just pulling her away.
CHP's Advanced Accident Investigation Team is now trying to determine the cause of the crash. Selena says she's seen multiple serious accidents on this same 101 overpass in her nearly 40 years of living in Soledad.
A better bridge, you know, it needs to be improved a lot, really a lot. You know, because, I mean, this, it's not going to stop. There's going to be accidents all the time.
Yeah, a lot of emotion, of course. A lot of families very worried tonight. We've learned that a 13-year-old was airlifted to a Fresno hospital, and tonight her father is trying to fly from France to come here and visit his daughter. We also know that CHP and Red Cross are trying to coordinate local housing somewhere in the area, some hotels for those who were on the bus as this investigation continues. Dan, Aaron.
All right, thanks very much, Stephanie.
All right, thanks, Steph. Many people who first arrived on scene are being heralded for their actions tonight. In fact, their quick action is being credited with helping save lives.
Our live team coverage continues now with Action News reporter Felix Cortez, who's also in Soledad tonight.
Well, Dan, Aaron, one paramedic described the scene as a nightmare, but for most of the emergency crews who responded to this accident, it was the worst they've ever seen. It was a gruesome scene, something many of the firefighters and paramedics had never seen in their careers. Some of their descriptions too graphic to describe.
So it was a pretty horrific scene when we got there. We had patients down by the railroad tracks that had been thrown off, and then we had all the patients in the bus. So a lot walking around, wounded.
By some accounts, the bus packed with French tourists rolled several times. Passengers were ejected. One was thrown from the overpass and died near some train tracks. Two others were pronounced dead at the scene.
It was something like I've never seen before. There was a lot of emergency vehicles and a lot of people that were hurt that were in need of medical care.
Marina police officer Eddie Anderson was on his day off when he saw the commotion and tried to help. 8 air ambulances were dispatched, 14 fire engines, and more than a dozen ambulances were called out. Rescue crews had the bus unloaded in an hour and a half, and then there was a language barrier.
Unfortunately, they were from France. Most of them didn't speak English. We had one young lady that was an interpreter, and she was a little altered, so she would help us when she could, and then but communication was challenging. But
one paramedic described the scene as a nightmare. She was too emotionally distraught to finish her shift and went home. Now the counseling and debriefing begins for her colleagues.
In the old days, we just went home and had nightmares and you dealt with it, but we don't do that anymore. We really do take care of our people. And
they take care of their firefighters by providing them counseling and debriefing, and that's what will happen tomorrow morning here at the Soledad Fire Station. Aaron, Dan.
All right, thanks very much, Felix.
Felix, thank you. Victims were fanned out to hospitals across the Central Coast. 3 critically injured patients were flown to San Jose.
And one of the most gravely injured died on arrival at Salinas Valley Memorial, while others have spent the afternoon and into the evening in surgery.
With more on the challenges medical personnel were facing, here is Brittany Nielsen, who filed this report from Salinas Valley Memorial.
Of the most critically injured from this evening's accident, 3 of them were brought here to Salinas Valley Memorial Hospital. Of those 3, one man confirmed dead from his injuries in this evening's accident. Another woman, in our last check, she was still in surgery, 35 years old and in surgery. A third woman facing the potential of surgery this evening. Now, this scene is taking place at several Central Coast hospitals, including Watsonville Community Hospital, Mi Memorial Hospital in King City, Natividad, and the Community Hospital of the Monterey Peninsula. We understand that no more patients will be brought here to Salinas Valley Memorial Hospital. Again, one patient in surgery, one facing surgery, and one man confirmed dead here at Salinas Valley Memorial Hospital. In Salinas, Brittany Nielsen, KSBW Action News 8.